गुड मॉर्निंग डॉक्टर्स, वेलकम अगेन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट एक्यूट कोरोनरी सिंड्रोम। अनदर टर्म फॉर दिस एक्यूट कोरोनरी सिंड्रोम इज एंजाइना, दैट इज अनस्टेबल। अनस्टेबल एंजाइना एंड एक्यूट कोरोनरी सिंड्रोम इज सेम। अनस्टेबल एंजाइना वी कॉल्ड व्हेन there is a chest pain on exertion and not relieved with rest is unstable angina. May represents myocardial infarction. So next step is always EKG. When patient with exertional chest pain not relieved by rest, go for EKG. And even if relieved by rest, go for EKG. Should also get cardiac enzymes, but first investigation is EKG. Should also give aspirin or clopidogrel if aspirin allergic, beta blocker or calcium channel blocker, nitrates and supportive oxygen we can use. Treatment will vary based on results of EKG and enzymes. Enzyme tell us if it's an MI or not. If high CKMB, then it is myocardial infarction. EKG help us determine if it is non-ST elevated MI or ST elevated MI. If enzymes are positive, put EKG is equivocal treatment as non-ST elevated MI. So here the treatment is like as non-ST elevated MI. If enzymes positive but ECG is normal, then it is considered as non-ST elevated MI. Okay. C. The cardiac enzymes. CKMB will be abnormally first 4 to 12 hours and also specific compared to troponin. It will also correct first after MI. Okay. Now, ST elevated and non-ST elevated, what is it? Both cause cardiac enzyme elevation. Even in non-ST elevated in myocardial infarction or ST elevated myocardial infarction, elevation of enzyme. Both are life-threatening emergencies that requires treatment. Both are life-threatening emergencies require treatment. Both can be anterior, lateral and inferior, etc. Now, difference between ST elevated, non-ST elevated MI. ST wave elevation MI is more severe occlusion which causes transmural full thickness ischemia of the myocardium. This results in an ST elevation in relevant leads. Fibrinolytics TPA are useful in the patient. Non-ST elevated MI is a blockage that causes superficial ischemia of the myocardium. This may but not always results in ST depression. In relevant leads, fibrinolytics are not useful in these patients. Okay. Let's see the ECG of non-ST elevated MI. See ST depression in V4, V5, V6 leads. So this is a case of lateral MI. When MI in V4, V5, V6, that means is lateral MI. If you stand in a position of ECG, then see your left hand comes in left side, so L for left, L for lateral, same. Okay. Now, baseline of the ECG, notice the baseline is depressed. This is seen on ECG of someone with non-ST elevated heart attack. See, non-ST elevation. Okay. Now, one more ECG about non-ST elevated. See here, the ST depression we see in lead V2, V3. So this is a case of anterior wall MI non-ST elevated. Okay. Now, how to treat non-ST elevated MI when EKG shows no ST elevation or ST elevation more than one, no ST elevation more than 1 mm in more than 2 leads or no left bundle branch block. Okay. While you are waiting for cardiac enzymes, treat with एस्पिरिन, बीटा ब्लॉकर्स, इपारिन, सपोर्टिव ऑक्सीजन, नाइट्रेट्स, नाइट्रोग्लिसरीन एंड मॉर्फिन. When we are going to wait for cardiac enzymes, till that time give a patient aspirin, beta blockers, heparin, supportive care, okay, nitroglycerin, morphine. Catheterization for angiography less than 12 hours of onset and cardiac enzymes come back positive, diagnose non-ST elevated MI. Patient has had prior intervention of PCI, CABG, has CHF, CKD, it's chronic kidney disease. Percutaneous intervention previous history or coronary artery bypass grafting previous history, congestive heart failure previous history, hypotension and prolonged pain, catheterized for angiography. Even enzymes are negative. Administer clopidogrel and GP2B3A inhibitor, aptifibatid and tirofiban if you are going to do angiography and potentially PCI. If more than 12 hours of onset or PCI fails, CABG indicated. When CABG is indicated, when PCI failed or more than 12 hours of duration. Okay. Now, ST elevated MI ECGC. We see ST elevation in V1, V2, V3, but T is too much high. It's a tall T due to hyperkalemia. But this is a case of ST elevated MI. And even in V1, we see V4, we see. So this is a case of anterior wall ST elevated MI, myocardial infarction. Okay. See the ST elevation here on the baseline of ECG. Now, already discussed. Now ST elevation we see in lead 2, 3 and AVF, not R. So this represents inferior wall MI. This represents inferior wall MI. Now if we see left bundle branch block, new findings. So this is a left bundle branch block after unstable angina, that means also consider as ST elevated MI. See left bundle branch block. How to identify left bundle branch block? This is M. See M. Sorry. M. M pattern in V4, V5, V6. That means left bundle branch block. Okay. Now recap little bit. If angina more than unstable angina more than 10 to 20 minutes not relieved by rest, order EKG and enzymes. First is EKG, then enzymes. If ST elevation or new left bundle branch block, STEMI, we will discuss later. Now if no ST elevation or new LBBB left bundle branch block, that means wait for enzymes. If enzymes are negative, no need to do nothing. During that time, give aspirin, beta blocker, heparin, supportive care, oxygen, nitrates, morphine. If enzyme negative, then only observation, 48 hours observation in hospital. If enzyme comes positive, patient has enzyme come positive, or if enzyme is negative but patient hypotensive, CKD, prior intervention, prolonged pain, less than 12 hours, do angiography and percutaneous intervention, angioplasty, and administer GP2B3A inhibitors or clopidogrel. Okay. If more than 12 hours, then CABG or PCI failed, do CABG. So guys, I finished about non-ST elevated MI. Let's discuss ST elevated MI treatment. Now, diagnose ST elevated MI when EKG shows ST elevation more than 1 mm in more than 2 leads or new left bundle branch block. EKG change are presumptive diagnosis. Start immediately aspirin, beta blocker, tissue plasminogen activator if less than 3 hours from onset. Supportive care oxygen, nitrates, nitroglycerin and morphine. Why here we are not going to use heparin because heparin prevents new formation of clots, and here is a complete occlusion. That's why we use tissue plasminogen activator, which reduces the formation of ready-made clot. Catheterization for angiography, administered clopidogrel GP2B3A inhibitor. Tissue plasminogen activator recanalization is successful. Perform PCI within 24 hours. If tissue plasminogen activator recanalization unsuccessful more than 3 hours from onset, contraindication for thrombolytics. Perform rescue PCI immediately. PCI failed, proceeds CABG thrombolysis. Never the final treatment. I already explained PCI or CABG. So angina lasting more than 10-20 minutes, not relieved by rest, EKG or enzymes. Enzymes comes positive or negative in spite, administered aspirin, beta blockers, catheterized angiography, GP2B, less than 3 hours, PCI, more than 3 hours or failed PCI, then CABG. Here if enzyme comes negative, in spite of negative enzymes, do the same treatment which I advise. So guys, I already finished with ST elevated, non-ST elevated MI. Thank you. Good day. Goodbye. That's all for today.